Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. So I plead the blood of Jesus over my channel, over you, and over myself, and over our families. Lord Jesus Christ, come guard our hearts and also protect us in your holy power and your holy authority. Lord, we command out any attacks from the enemy's camp and send them back from whence they came by your power and authority, Jesus Christ. Amen. I was reading last night before I went to bed, and I just said, Jesus, teach me. And he led me to Luke 18, the parable of the widow, the parable of the persistent widow. It says here, then Jesus told his disciples a parable to show them that they should always pray and not give up. He said, in a certain town, there was a judge who neither feared God nor cared about men. And there was a widow in that town who kept coming to him with the plea, grant me justice against my adversary. For some time he refused, but finally he said to himself, even though I don't fear God or care about men, yet because this widow keeps bothering me, I will see that she gets justice so that she won't eventually wear me out with her coming. So he's doing it basically, because she was more of an annoyance to him, not because he cared about justice. And before I turn the page, I want to talk about this. My Bible is the NIV Study Bible, and that's why I like it, because it shows me correlating scripture and it also gives me commentary. So 18:1 says, does this mean we shouldn't stop praying for something even when God says no? Jesus wants our faith to remain strong no matter how our prayers are answered. He wants us to trust God even when things don't go the way we want. We can stop praying for something specific if God somehow indicates answer is no, which may open an opportunity for something else. It's like if God shuts a door, sorry. If God shuts a door, sometimes we're pulling on the knob and wondering why. That door isn't being opened, but sometimes and almost always, God has something better, something that He's going to bless us with even more. Okay, so also if we go to 2:7, why compare God to an uncaring, unjust judge? Jesus was not comparing, but contrasting. If an unjust judge eventually listens to a widow, how much more quickly will a caring, loving God respond to one of his children? Jesus argues from lesser to greater. Okay, so this was just, it hit my spirit, you know, how you read something from the Bible and you're just like, wow. Okay, so this 18:6 says, and the Lord said, listen to what the unjust judge says. And will not God bring justice for his chosen ones? Who cry out to him day and night, will he keep putting them off? I tell you, he will see that they get justice and quickly. However, when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on the earth? I believe he's talking about the apostasy. I can't speak for Jesus, but I just wanted to share that with you. And I couldn't get my computer to print today. You know, I always have struggles with my electronics, but I just wanted to point out the commentary here, and I can add the links for this. But it talks in this chapter the parable of the importune widow, okay, and designed to teach us fervency in prayer, verse 1 through 8. The parable of the Pharisees and publican, designed to teach us humility for sin and prayer. And you know what? Jesus loves humility and prayer. He loves us to humble ourselves to Him and to ask for forgiveness. I repent every day when I sin, and the closer you get to the Lord Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, you will be even more convicted by the Holy Spirit when you sin. So I'll continue. Christ's favor to little children that were brought to him. Verse 15 and 17, the trial of a rich man that had a mind to follow Christ. Whether he loved better Christ or his riches, he's coming short upon the trial. This is continuing on for the whole chapter of 18. But it's, let me just go to verse 1 through 8 because that is the most, the ones that he pointed out to me. This parable has its key hanging at the door. The drift and design of it is prefixed. Christ spoke it with this intent to teach us that men always to pray and not grow faint. It supposes that all God's people are praying people. All God's children keep up both a constant and an occasional correspondence with him. Send to him stately and upon every emergency. It is our privilege and honor that we may pray. Okay, and I'm not going to read the whole commentary, but I just felt like this was very significant, especially now. Sorry, my hands are all over the place. I'm sorry. But it's very significant because we have a just judge. This judge with the widow was not a just judge, but we do have a just judge. And Jesus is coming back as the judge. But I just felt it was very significant that even though the judge was unjust, the one that was dealing with the widow, he did say, when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth? So we must not grow weary. We must go to Jesus and ask for his help, for his restoration, for his strength. You know, the body of Christ, we are under attack. And that is why we need to come together and not be divided. But Jesus loves his children, and he is a just judge. And he will come back to judge, and he will wipe the wicked from the earth. But I just wanted to share this. I hope this encourages somebody that's going through something. I know that I lean on Jesus a lot, and I am learning. So I just wanted to share. I try to share what he shares with me, what he puts upon my heart to share. So God bless you. I pray for you every single day, and I love you. Amen.